to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, are there any changes to the agenda? Ted?
Yes.
Anything that needs to be added to tonight's agenda?
No, I just wanted to show you all some of the drawings and signs.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, let me do it.
Just do that one?
Yeah.
All right.
And table the votes from the landscape permit, so I don't want to...
Oh, we're gonna table?
If you can, if you want, if you could, I think it'd be best, so you know, the last one will be completed. I have three. One of them put in there for some top zones, some other things that's not needed, so...
Should we go ahead and look at it a little bit?
Curious, but...
I'd love to see it.
54, 42, and 33.
So they're all down.
Why don't we go ahead and at least look at what you have, the top, since we're here.
Special trees. They're guaranteed to...
Not red, but errors. Don't do red, but errors.
No, okay. All right, so we'll go ahead and do the appointment to the park board, and I will move that we appoint Don Simler to the Whitestown Park Board in the position that Matt Simler was in, but he withdrew his candidacy for...
Resigned.
Resigned from the board once he became park board.
I'll second the motion.
So we have motions and seconded. Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say no. Motion adopted, or...
Carries.
Don Simler is appointed for...
Does she have a meeting for me?
Yes.
All right, and now we will move on to looking at these appointments.
Make copies of the last one.
So where on Parkway did this street, or the street in our number? Down here?
So a good majority of median is skinny, or just for the turn lane, the stacking lanes, the turn lanes. But where you do have width, where you do have that 4 to 6 feet, that's where the landscaping will be. If you want a good example of what it will look like, the Maple Grove entrance, very nice. All gravel, trees in the gravel, shrubs up front. Their plantings are very nice. Ours will be a little more enhanced because there will be more plantings than theirs has. But that's the vision of for the project. Now, I can tell you that the high quote, all three of these companies are water wise. All three do very good work. The high quote Vibram does all of the Anson work. Mike Brush does all of our work for the town. So thus far, he does the fertilizing. He maintains all the landscaping here at the municipal complex. He did all the lighting and the flagpoles. And then you have Turf Boss, which is also located. There is not a, the difference here is you're getting quotes. There hasn't been an architect come in, a landscape architect come in. I was trying to save that money. We can have that done. We can start all over again here. We can have a landscape architect come in, do drawings, draw it up, do a scope, send that scope out to the world, get it quoted. Likely two things will happen there. Number one, you're going to have to pick the landscape architect to work. And number two, when that landscape architect is finished, the quote's probably going to come go from $35,000 to $54,000 to $170,000. Just because landscape architects will say, if you want this done right, this is what the design's going to look like.
They're mostly similar, at least in quotes.
I sent out for quotes, and I said, this is what we want in the meeting.
This quantity.
Everybody is the same, except for Vibram does have a little bit of design. They did a little bit of a design in their quote. The topsoil could, I told him, he did not think the topsoil was placed in the median. And I sent him an email, I said, topsoil was in fact placed in the median. But I did not tell him, when I sent out the quotes, I did not say anything about topsoil. It wasn't even in my email. So I was going to, I emailed him tonight, I said, I see your quote as topsoil. I want you to be apples to apples compare apples to apples here. Now, I don't know if Turf Boss and your Tiny's going to be on them. If Turf Boss and Brush Landscape, nowhere on their quote do you see the word topsoil. Because I'm assuming they assumed that it was already there. We did have quite a bit of dirt brought into those sections. Yeah, I'm glad that's just a typo.
Okay. So in theory, they're the same plants.
Yes.
It has disappeared.
That is correct. No, because that'll be all concrete. It won't have any center section. There's not enough room to make it one. If we take over all the lane space we can and create lanes. It's just low ground planting. It's a flowering plant. So you got trees and you have kind of what we have in this median out here. I mean, that costs $4,500. It's amazing.
I'm not saying anything about the cost right now. I'm just, my non-green thumb is having a really hard time understanding what each of these little things this is going to be planted.
Small flowering plants. Yeah, I don't think there's any grasses. If I'm looking at this right, there are no grasses. These are going to be hardy plants that will survive, you know, the oil. Well, salt obviously they're dead by then anyway. They will be perennial, so they'll come up every year.
But all these are plants that are going to grow no taller than 1.5 to 2 feet off the ground.
They can't because the trees can. Now, trees, you couldn't plant pine trees in the middle of the median. You couldn't do it. There's a certain standard that, you know, a tree has to get so high, branches have to be cut, and mm-hmm. you have to be able to see through them.
So there are no trees, but there are trees.
There are trees. I'm telling you what I'm saying. What I just said is you couldn't plant blue spruces in the median.
Right. So on here, because I don't know what any of these names really are, because I also have no green thumbs. Plants die around me, plus the weeds. So which ones are the trees?
I think
the red sunset.
Red sunset, 2-inch.
Or maples, Armstrong.
The Armstrong maples are your trees.
Okay.
Armstrong maples grow this way.
Okay.
They don't grow this way. They grow straight up and down. They go straight down and they go straight up. You're not going to have roots.
Do they split? And hybrids?
Not like silver maples, no. These, Armstrong maple doesn't get very thick either. They never get a lot of thickness. So we're not going to have oaks in the middle of the park.
How tall do we expect the trees to get to?
I haven't asked, but I think that Armstrong maples are over in the median in, or a similar variety, but out of white. And so they're probably 25 feet at the most.
You said 4 to 5 or 25?
25 feet. Yeah. That was chosen by these professionals.
Okay.
We said we need a tree to go straight up and straight down. That can be planted in a meeting.
And that's a root system that doesn't corrupt the asphalt?
Oh, yeah. You wouldn't need anything else, correct. You also don't want a tree blowing over a vehicle. So you want it to be strong in your road. Hindsight being 2020, we would have made this part of the bid, but we were trying to save as much money at that time as possible. And to enable us to encumber this out of last year when we aged.
And we're prepared to take on the maintenance for all this stuff, right?
Yes, that's why you've got a facility maintenance person in our budget, which we have conducted a few interviews for today.
What would be the expected maintenance though? A couple of fertilizer applications throughout the year, maybe some weed pulling?
Well, here's right now we Mike Rush does the maintenance for all the plantings here. He did not put them in. But he does all the maintenance for these plantings, the one that meeting out there. His guys come in for pretty cheap actually. Come in, cut things down, get them ready in the spring. We'll occasionally come in probably July or August, take any dead out, take any trash out, weeds, and then come through at the end of the year, come back in the winter. So you're looking at three times a year doing your typical maintenance on any kind of landscape. Mike's doing that for us now. And he does it. They do a really good job. Very reliable. They did a great job. I get so many compliments on the black poles. There's a rock around it, plastic around that sign. He does very good work. Now, he's even mentioned adopting a median, which means that I don't know if I didn't ask him point blank. Does that mean you'll be doing this maintenance on the median pro bono as for advertising purposes?
But worst case scenario, we're thinking 3 to 4 times a year, maximum half day each time.
Correct. Ground level drawings, you know, 30,000-foot or 10,000-foot drawing, that's where they come into play. Ben has drawn in the median, and what I meant by it, he's got the kind of flowing, the plants kind of flow and curve, and you have a tree and the plants flow and curve and the tree.
So it's the basic drawing there.
Okay. Yeah.
So I'm just trying to think of the space that we're trying to fill, that it happens only every so often, that'd be a lot of cost to get the natural architect from drawing from the space that we're dealing with.
Yeah.
So if they have a basic drawing,
if they have a basic drawing, I mean, I would imagine that's going to be pretty similar for everybody.
You said Byron has a little design to it. What do you mean by that?
So can you try to basic drawings on the other two before, what is it, the 13, 30?
So the median word, I can turn that up a little bit.
It's good. Gives us something to do in the summer.
Not at all. Your
theory is tall grass is a median, so in roundabouts are okay, but I'm not going to go there right now. You're supposed to actually come to the stop.
I think tall grass is just for roundabouts.
They took a hybrid or a concept of the two, and we get a stone, this faux stone base with the aluminum background, and that's a curved feature. Welcome to Whitestown, that's curved. That's also aluminum, and then the big background is aluminum as well. You see how big it is with the human being standing next to it.
Said, these are our gateways, and this is what we want it to look like.
So we're kind of piecemealing this together, but in my opinion, we need signage on this parkway right now, today, because people come off the park.
But I think, which I think the design you've chosen is, I like it, I really like it, and I think it'd be fine up there.
You want the big one and the small?
Yeah, I mean, to replicate that up the other end as well, because.
Yes, we need one of ours, right, and one on 300 to come in, but baby steps, right?
Yeah, because that's the other wall, so.
That's the other way, certainly is. They do a lot of work for Lebanon, they do a lot of work for, it didn't do Brownsburg, if you drive through Brownsburg, Brownsburg just threw out their sign package, it's nice. What they've just done is really nice, you know, when you're.
When the bypass comes through, it's an excellent place right for the.
Yes. This is the way I so far, I don't have a third quote, I don't think we, and I know that we would like it from a public spending perspective. And we can call more, but it's really hard to believe how many of these companies don't do this. I've called quite a few, and they don't get into the big municipal, outdoor, long-lasting signage. We can find it, we can still search. I talked to Mark at Indy Pro briefly. This is not their, this is not, he does great work. He did great work for us in here from a bio perspective and the little, and you know.
They can do future home signs great, but this isn't
important. I'm saying this on camera, I don't want to be mad at me. I don't think that this is their, what they do best at selling, I guess. Like or not, it's not some kind of contractor.
So,
I just wanted to let you know that because we worked so hard on this, tonight's a good night to do it since we're all here, except Councilman Russell. It's nearing an end of some kind. I like it a lot.
Got it all figured out.
You're not upstairs then?
No.